Magandang araw, Kapamilya. Today is Saturday of the fourth week of Easter. Our Mass presider is Father Tito Caluag. Entrance Antiphon. O chosen people, proclaim the mighty works of Him who called you out of darkness into His wonderful light. Alleluia.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins and ask the Lord for pardon and strength. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
And let us pray. O God, who in the celebration of Easter graciously gave the world the healing of heavenly remedies, show benevolence to your church, that our present observance may benefit us for eternal life. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. On the following Sabbath, almost the whole city gathered to hear the word of the Lord. When the Jews saw the crowds, they were filled with jealousy and with violent abuse, contradicted what Paul said. Both Paul and Barnabas spoke out boldly and said, "It was necessary that the word of God be spoken to you first. But since you reject it and condemn yourselves as unworthy of eternal life, we now turn to the Gentiles. For so the Lord has commanded us, 'I have made you a light to the Gentiles, that you may be an instrument of salvation to the ends of the earth.'" The Gentiles were delighted when they heard this and glorified the word of the Lord. All who were destined for eternal life came to believe, and the word of the Lord continued to spread through the whole region. The Jews, however, incited the women of prominence who were worshippers and the leading men of the city, stirred up a persecution against Paul and Barnabas, and expelled them from their territory. So they shook the dust from their feet in protest against them and went to Iconium. The disciples were filled with joy in the Holy Spirit. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm. All the ends of the earth have seen the saving power of God.
All the ends of the earth have seen the saving power of God.
Sing to the Lord a new song, for He has done wondrous deeds. His right hand has won victory for Him, His holy arm.
All the ends of the earth have seen the saving power of God.
The Lord has made His salvation known. In the sight of the nations He has revealed His justice. He has remembered His kindness and His faithfulness toward the house of Israel.
All the ends of the earth have seen the saving power of God.
All the ends of the earth have seen the salvation by our God. Sing joyfully to the Lord, all you lands. Break into song. Sing praise.
All the ends of the earth have seen the saving power of God.
Alleluia, alleluia. If you remain in my word, you will truly be my disciples, and you will know the truth, says the Lord. Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A proclamation of the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to His disciples, "If you know me, then you will also know my Father. From now on, you do know him and have seen him." Philip said to Jesus, "Master, show us the Father, and that will be enough for us." Jesus said to him, "Have I been with you for so long a time, and you still do not know me, Philip? Whoever has seen me has seen the Father. How can you say, 'Show us the Father'? Do you not believe that I am in the Father and the Father is in me? The words that I speak to you, I do not speak on my own. The Father who dwells in me is doing His works. Believe me that I am in the Father and the Father is in me, or else believe because of the works themselves. Amen, amen, I say to you, whoever believes in me will do the works that I do, and will do greater ones than these, because I am going to the Father. And whatever you ask in my name, I will do, so that the Father may be glorified in the Son. If you ask anything of me in my name, I will do it. My dear brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Today we again, you know, continue to deepen our reflections on the final discourse, no? The final discourse, again, as I mentioned, as we keep on mentioning the last few days, from the perspective now both of the resurrection, of the mystery of the resurrection, and the ascension, no? Because we saw this looking at it now from the mystery of the cross, no? So now you have the mystery of the resurrection and ascension, as we mentioned also the last few days. And these are really perspectives of mission, no? Perspectives of mission. So tingnan natin ulit itong final discourse ng Panginoon, ano? Na sabi nga natin mga nakarang araw, ito ngayon ay binibigyan natin ng konteksto at pagnilalay mula sa perspektiba ng muling pagkabuhay at ng pag-akyat sa langit, no? Hindi kagaya nung nakaraan, ang tingin natin ay ang pananaw natin ay ang nalalapit na kamatayan ng Panginoon sa krus, no? Kaya nga talagang ang konteksto talaga ay higit na yung misyon na yung mission magiging mission ng simbahan, kagaya ng nabanggit natin kahapon ata, ano. So when we take a look at this, so we take a look at again mission, ano. And now the mission that the quality or the characteristic of mission that the Lord emphasizes here is, they said, the Father and I are one, no. So this the mission that we have is union with God, no. And then the second point that I invite you to reflect on is that, again, the Lord says here, no, that the words that I say are the words of the Father, and the works that I do is the Father working in me, no. So here again you see now that very deep rootedness of Jesus, and therefore his mission, his works and his words in the Father, in his relationship with the Father, no. So then the last one that we will look at is that at the very end, no, again a very assuring word from Christ, ask and you shall receive, no. So siguro itong tatlong punto ito, lahat ng ito ay talagang may pagtukoy sa ating sa buhay ng ating misyon, no. Yung unang punto na sinabi natin ay yung misyon na nagmumula sa sabi ng Panginoon, ang Diyos at ang Ama at ako ay iisa, no. Na siguro ito yung malalim na ugnayan or union, no, pagkakaisa ng Ama at Anak, diyan nagbubunga ang ating misyon, no. At yung pangalawang punto ng pagninilay natin ay yung sinabi ng Panginoon na ito pagpapalalim ng kanilang pagkakaisa, no. Sabi niya, lahat ng salita ko ay salita ng Ama. At lahat ng gawa ko ay ang Ama na kumikilos sa akin. At yung huling punto na pagninilayan natin, yung sabi ng Panginoon, humingi kayo. Humingi kayo at ibibigay ito sa iyo, no. Dahil nga ang Panginoon siya mismo ang hihingi sa Ama. Dahil siya ay papunta na sa Ama, no. So when we take a look at that entire notion of the Father and I are one, you know, it reminds me of what Ignatius said. Ignatius said, no, that in the end our goal in life is union with God. Remember in the first principle and foundation, Ignatius said, you know, we were created, we are being created. God continues to sustain us to praise, reverence, and serve God. And through this means, attain union with God, no? And you know, when you take a look at also that kind of drive or passion or very focused work of Ignatius, no? He said, no, everything was about saving souls. Everything was about bringing people to union with God. And I think that is the gospel for today reminds us of that, no? That what lies at the center of all the works that we do, of our mission, is to attain union with God. Yes, our own union, because it is through living out God's mission for us that we attain eternal life, no? But also the mission itself is to save souls, no? That was a constant refrain in Ignatius, to save souls, that all the works and the apostolates, no, was really geared towards saving souls, no? And I think that is very, very central to that mission, no? So the Father and I are one. It is union with God, no? Union with God. Yung unang punto na yon, na makikita natin na yan ang isa sa pinakamalalim na masasabi natin katangian ng misyon, no? Na ang misyon ay talagang dapat maghatid sa atin sa pagkakaisa natin sa Diyos, no? Na bagaman ang ating misyon ay isa buhay ang nais gustong paggawa ng Diyos sa atin na may mapagmahal na pagtalima. Pero tandaan natin, ang bunga nito ay ang pagkakaisa natin sa Diyos, our union with God, no? So I think that is very central to mission, no? And then the second thing about mission is that we reflected on this also earlier this week, no? When Christ said, no, the words that I say comes from the Father, and the works that I do is the Father working in me, no? And here you have that union and intimacy in action, no? And I think this is something very, very interesting, no? That Christ saying that because of my ministry, no, I attain deeper union with my Father, because precisely the words that I preach, the works that I do, all of these come from the Father. And the more he fulfills his work and fulfills his preaching ministry, you see now that the deepening of that union, no? And siguro mahalaga na mapagnilayan natin to, no? Kasi para sa akin ang isang pinapahiwatig dito ay ang integridad ng isang taong nabubuhay sa mission. I think this characteristic of mission is integrity. Integrity in what we say, integrity what we do, and the source of that integrity is the Father. That the source of Christ's integrity, his words and his works, was because of the Father. And that is part of the mission we are called to. And that is the grace of the mission that we are given, no? Siguro, yung puntong ito, magandang palalimin, ano? Magandang palalimin na makita natin na lahat talaga ay nag-uugat mula sa Ama, yung ating malalim na ugnayan sa Ama, at nagbubunga rin dahil dito, no? And then the last point is ask and you shall receive, no? And then here, no, the Lord said, ask anything in my name and I will do it, no? And for me that is a very, very important detail, no? It's not simply ask and you will receive, but what the Lord is saying, ask and I will do it, no? Again, when you think about it, no, the Lord is saying, you know, if you do the work that I do and you ask for the grace, no, to be able to do the work, again, Christ is the one doing it in us, no? In the same way that he says that it is the Father working through him in the works that he does. So also now, no, the Lord is saying, ask and I will do it for you. He does not simply say, ask and you will receive. Ask and I will actively guide you, lovingly guide you. I will be present to you. And again, you know, I go back to that, what we've mentioned several times over the past week, no? Remember, one of our favorite lines is, you know, grace is always available, but we must ask for it to have an effect in our lives. Here, the Lord reiterates that, no? In a somewhat different way. Ask and I will do it for you. Open yourself to grace and I will come and do it for you. For me, that's a very powerful assurance that for us who remain faithful to mission, that is a promise of the Lord. Siguro magandang talagang palalimin natin ang ating pag-unawa at ang ating pag-appreciate doon sa sinabi ng Panginoon, ano, na kung tayo ay talagang magiging tapat sa ating misyon, sa gagawin, sa pinagagawa sa atin, sa pakikibahagi natin sa misyon ng Panginoon, sabi niya, humingi kayo ng grasya, humingi kayo ng biyaya, at ako mismo ang gagawa. So today, let us pray, no, that we deepen this appreciation of and faith in our mission. In the name of the Father, of the Son, of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let us pray to our Father that He shows us the way of Christ, the way to Christ, who is our way, truth, and life.
That the presence of Jesus, who is our truth, may be perceived through our lives, witness, and examples, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That public officials may lead the people in the ways of justice, peace, and unity, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That dignity and hope in life may be restored among the marginalized of our society, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer. And let us remember all the intentions commended to our prayers at this Mass. For all this we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that this, our sacrifice, may be made acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
Graciously sanctify these gifts, O Lord, we pray, and accepting the oblation of this spiritual sacrifice, make of us an everlasting offering to you, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord. But in this time, above all, to laud you yet more gloriously when Christ, our Passover, has been sacrificed. Through him, the children of light rise to eternal life, and the halls of the heavenly kingdom are thrown open to the faithful. For his death is our ransom from death, and in his rising the life of all has risen. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise. And even the heavenly powers with angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the night that he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, he gave you thanks. He broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Again, he gave you thanks and praise. He gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, this life-giving bread, this saving cup. We thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, Onesto, our Bishop, the clergy, the entire people your Son has gained for you. Accept, Father most holy, all the intentions commended to our prayers at this Mass. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them, Lord, into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have blessed you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin and protect us from all anxiety as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Lord, we beg you not to look on our sins but on the faith of your church, and grant us the peace, the unity, and the joy of your kingdom where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
My dear brothers and sisters, behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away our sins, the sin of the world. Happy are we who are called to share in the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
And let us spend a few moments of silence. And together now, let us offer our prayer of humble faith and hope.
Merciful and compassionate Father, we humbly come before you in faith and hope. Grant us your grace and guidance as we emerge from this pandemic. We thank you for the blessings that saw us through the challenges of the past years. Reward those who selflessly served and continue to serve our many needs. Console those who suffered. Heal the sick. Grant eternal rest to those who died. May we draw inspiration from our collective and individual experiences. Let our hearts burn within us to build a world closer to your kingdom of justice, truth, equality, peace, joy, faith, hope, compassion, and love. May each of us be a bright candle to remind us that light will overcome darkness and never the other way around. We pray for our nation. Give us the courage and inspiration to relentlessly take part in the project of building a nation that our founding fathers envisioned over a century ago, and to which succeeding generations offer their lives in dedicated service, some to the point of martyrdom. Heroes, also Filipinos, may continue to work for freedom and someday truly be free. Grant all these through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Our Lady of the Immaculate Conception, Patroness of the Philippines,
pray for us.
Our Lady, help of all Christians and health of the sick.
Pray for us.
Our Lady of Fatima.
Pray for us.
Saint Joseph.
Pray for us.
Saint Raphael the Archangel.
Pray for us.
Saint Roch.
Pray for us.
Saint Lorenzo Ruiz.
Pray for us.
Saint Pedro Calungsod.
Pray for us.
Most Sacred Heart of Jesus.
Have mercy on us.
Santo Niño de Cebu.
Have mercy on us.
Divine Mercy.
Have mercy on us. And let us pray. We have partaken of the gifts of this sacred mystery, humbly imploring, O Lord, that what your Son commanded us to do in memory of him may bring us growth in charity through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And Almighty God bless us, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Let us go in peace to love and to serve the Lord and one another.
Thanks be to God.
Yan, marami pong salamat for joining us. And again, we invite you to watch Proyecto Pilipino. As I mentioned yesterday, we have a very good episode this week on the study of the Ateneo School of Government on the political dynasties. This is part, actually, the political dynasty topic is part of the civics curriculum of the DepEd. So we're really trying to follow the curriculum as best as we can also, unless there are parang special concerns that arise. No? So please join us for Proyecto Pilipino. Our guest is Dean Tuanyo of the Ateneo School of Government. And then also for Journeys of Hope, we have BGYO Jello as our guest this weekend. Maraming pong salamat. Have a good Saturday ahead. Have a good weekend ahead.
The Alikapa Community Schooling is a program of Caritas Philippines in partnership with Unilab Foundation, Center for Integrated STEM, Diocese of Novaliches, and Magna Anima Teachers College. Our main goal is to provide education, employment, and skills trainings to our out-of-school youth. We aim to give them a better future with this program. Currently, we have 95 students, 48 junior high school, and 49 senior high school. I am Benjamin Custodio of Team Caritas Philippines. We are inviting you to support out-of-school youth through Alay Kapa Community Schooling.